Okay, we're going to be taking a look at the Pro version of Microsoft Forms. Forms is included in Office 365, and the Pro edition is additional to that. What it has is additional options that analyze the data that you get back, and it also has additional options to send the surveys out. Microsoft put some example data in Forms that you can use to look at these options, so that's actually what we're going to use. So I've gone into what's called a customer satisfaction survey. And there's three sections that we can look at, which is creating the questions, sending the surveys, and viewing the responses. The creating the questions isn't largely different from Microsoft Forms that isn't Pro, so we won't spend a lot of time here. If you want to see a video about how to create these different types of questions, I've linked to another video up in the upper right-hand corner. But this video is just going to focus on the differences that make this Pro. So those would start in the send survey area. You have a couple of different options here. The first one is to email, and when we left click on this, you're already going to see some differences. So the one is that the email editor is built in instead of launching Outlook. And there are some advantages that you get here from it being built in. The one is that there are links ready to be inserted that are the survey link and an unsubscribe link. And you can also put in first name and last name that would correspond with each of the people that you are sending it to. That can make the survey look a little bit more personal when it comes into someone's email inbox. And you can also choose from some templates. So if you left click on default template, and let's say you're looking for some feedback on an event, just left click this, and it's going to give you some just better starting sentences that you can then customize from there. So that's what we pick up by using the built-in email editor. Let's go back to the top to look at some other options. We covered email. The next is integration with Microsoft Flow. So Microsoft Flow is its own app that you would find in the upper left-hand corner. Yeah, and you would launch that, but Microsoft Flow will create certain actions based on responses. So you could have something like if you built an app with Microsoft Power Apps and the person using the app said, this app is terrible, it could launch them into the survey and that survey response would then flow through Microsoft Forms Pro. So another example of using Microsoft Flow might be if you send out a customer survey after you have a sale on a website. So that would be another trigger. It would trigger the flow, send the survey out to someone who just purchased a product. There's other ways to integrate Microsoft Flow, but just to know that's here and that's an option now. So you can look further into that. And then the embed option has been expanded. This will give you some code that you can put on your website that will put a Microsoft form on your site, and there's a few different ways to do it. So now you can do it just as an inline embed. So this is a representation of your website, and the form would just go in line with everything else. You could have it be a pop-up, or you could embed a button that you would click on that would launch the form. You can also pass some parameters in the embed code if you wanted. You could check them here. And once you got the code, you would just log into the back end of your website and paste the HTML in. You would use this button here called Generate Code, but that's turned off because this is all just sample data. You can also just grab the link. So this is available in the regular Microsoft Forms, just like this too, because all it is a link. And you would use that link, say maybe to create an email with your own HTML code and use this link, or you could just send it to someone. They could click on it. And this option is also available in regular forms, but you could say print this out that someone else could scan and it would bring them to the form. So that covers these options that have been added to send the survey out, but there's also a lot of enhancements in Forms Pro about how to view the responses. So the responses that Microsoft put in here, there's enough of them that these dynamics kind of make sense, and that's why I'm using the sample data. I could create my own and just give it four or five responses, but then all of these analytics wouldn't be very helpful. Okay, so if you don't currently have Office 365, If you go down and look at the description in the video, I have a link there that'll give you more information. And it is an affiliate link, so if you use that, you'll help to support my channel, which of course I would really appreciate. And once you sign up for Office 365, the option to upgrade to Pro is available. First, we'll go over the overview, which focuses on the responses as a whole to all of the questions. And then we can look at the question responses to specific questions. All of these tiles are links. So for example, if I click on the 100 responses, I left click on it, and there's a Power BI backend here that's analyzing this data. And it's come up with 4 stats that it thinks are relevant that tells us about the forms. And if you hover over one of them, this is the Net Promoter Score. This is trying to tell me how happy people were. So you have people that were in a passive, but then you have promoters and detractors. And you can click around in here and it'll highlight it and hover over it and show you a little bit more information. But clicking on these will make a little bit more sense as we go on here. So that's the responses. If you look at the invitations that were sent, so this focuses on all of them, not just those that were responded to. Some of these I don't think filled out right. But this will be a graphical representation of how many people sent it back, you know, answered the survey. And there's also the detail below in all of these. And if you wanted to, you could export it all or you could export it line by line. If you think you had some bad data that was sent back, you could just delete it. If you drill down into sentiment, this is Microsoft trying to figure out how happy the people are again. But there's some more interesting cards here. So among people who answered product knowledge in 2, which feature influenced the rating the most, et cetera, et cetera. It thinks that it's come up with something useful here. And we can click through these. There's a couple of these analysis and these come automatically. They used artificial intelligence to try to come up with some interesting relationships. So after you send your data out, some of these cards might provide some helpful insight to you, but you won't know it until you try it. If you go to question responses, this looks at the responses to individual questions. So this one was a star rating that you would give a certain question. If I scroll down to some of these charts, they are interactive. So let's look at number 3, for example, the detractors. There'll be 34 responses. If I left click on that, this chart changes. So you can see if I come up here and in the product knowledge 35, I left click on that, these charts change as well. So they're designed to give you the ability to drill down into what it's telling you. This last one's kind of neat looking. It creates a word cloud. And that's based on the responses that people typed in. So you can maybe gain some sentiment here. Or you can always left click on more details and it will bring you to the underlying data.